failure after failure after failure. Everything was confusing. I read the manual 13 times, still don't get it. And so you just kind of feel lost and confused and kind of hopeless. What am I doing here? Imposter syndrome can allow you to live in fear.
Sometimes you have this great grand unified theory that puts together all this information, and you think it would be such a beautiful system if that's how the biology worked. But biology doesn't always fit into what we want it to.
Initially, it's extremely frustrating. There's this sense of, this is happening because I messed up. And a better, more experienced researcher would have moved far past where I'm currently at a long time ago.
It happens at any stage of your career. 10 years later, after starting my PhD, now I would be failure-free? I am not, right?
The big figures in science have a lot of failures behind them and a lot of failures to come, but they've embraced it and realized, you know, it's all a learning opportunity.
There's so many failures. You know, most of what you do in the lab, it doesn't work or, you know, is wrong. And you have to constantly drive to fix it.
I remember after my first year in grad school, I was trying to clone this gene. I had the hard time cloning. And I called my dad and said, well, you know, I don't know if this is going to really work for me. Maybe I should just quit grad school. It was a low moment because I had so much trouble.
There are many other threads, experiments over the years that just didn't come to fruition. A huge amount of work and effort on too many things that I could even tell you about.
We have the leeway, not necessarily to fail, but to explore areas that are so unknown that it's kind of expected that we run into roadblocks. So don't take this as a sign that you've messed up. Take this as a sign, I think, that you're doing real research. Failure is an inherent, inseparable part of science.